Welcome. In this video, we'll see how to detect a key press and activate relay using interrupt technique. So this key is connected to pin RB0 of PIC16F877 microcontroller. So this pin is also the external interrupt pin for this microcontroller. So whenever this key is pressed, an interrupt will be generated, and using that interrupt, we are going to activate this relay. And the program for activating this relay will be written in interrupt service routine. So now this is the circuit. So whenever the key is pressed, the relay will be activated. That is the output of this program. So that will be written with the help of interrupts. So now let's see how to write the program for this circuit. So this is the template file that I have taken from microchip folder for PIC16F877 microcontroller. So in this, the main program will start at 00 address location. So from this address location, the actual program starts. So first instruction is NOP, so it does nothing. Next instruction is go to main. So whenever this instruction is executed, it will jump to main label, so which is right here. So whenever this main program starts executing, in that main program, we have first of all initialized the pin RB0 as input pin. So that is done with the help of BSF TRISB, 0. So RB0 pin will be configured as input pin. And then the pin to which the relay is connected, that pin is configured as output pin. So that pin is port E. Pin number 1, that is RE1 pin. So we need to clear the position of that bit in TRISE register. So now this pin will be configured as output pin. Next, we have configured the INTCON register. So INTCON register stands for interrupt control register. So in this, there is a format for this register. So in that, the first we have set the two bits, that is GIE, that is global interrupt enable bit. We have made it 1 so that an interrupt will be allowed to execute. And apart from that, we have also enabled the external interrupt bit, that is INTE is equal to 1, and rest all the bits in INTCON register are made equal to 0. After that, we have also configured the interrupt edge. So that can be configured with the help of option register. So in that, we have a bit called as INTEDG. So whenever this bit is cleared, then we'll have a falling edge interrupt. So interrupt will be generated on falling edge on external interrupt pin, that is RB0 pin. And after that, we have just created an infinite loop. And in this loop, it will just wait for interrupt to occur. So instead of having this loop, you can write any other program inside this loop. That program will keep on running, and whenever an interrupt is generated, it will stop this program and it will go to ISR, execute the ISR and come back to the main program. But in this case, we have not written any program. Also, sometimes if you are going to run this program in hardware, then you may require delay subroutine, because a relay may not be activated in such a fast time, so we need some delay. So that's why a delay can also be included. In this program, I have not included the delay, since I am just going to do it on a simulation software, that is Proteus. So this is the main program. Now next is the interrupt service routine. So by default, the vector address for PIC16F877 is ORG004 hex. So from this address location, the ISR will start. So since again, I have taken a template file, inside that template file, we have all these instructions, inbuilt instructions, which are used for saving the context. So we are not going to see about those instructions. We'll just see the ISR code. So in this, we have just selected the bank in which port E register is present, and we have set that port pin, that is the pin to which the relay is connected, that pin is made equal to 1 to activate the relay. So the program will come to this point whenever an interrupt is generated, and interrupt will be generated whenever key is pressed, right? So next here you can include delay if you are going to run this program on the hardware, but in case of software that delay is not required. Next, using these two instructions, we have just checked whether the key is released or not. So once the key is pressed, it will come to ISR and it will remain in ISR till the key is pressed. So whenever the key is released, the relay should be turned off. So if the key is not released, it will remain in this loop, and whenever the key is released, it will come out of the loop and it will execute this instruction. So using this instruction, the relay is deactivated. After that, again, we have selected the bank in which INTCON register is present, and this is an important thing, that is, we have to clear the flag which is related to external interrupt, that is INTF. So before using this interrupt for the next time, we have to make sure that this flag is cleared. So for that purpose, we have to execute this instruction. So this is about the program. Now we'll see how to check the output on the Proteus software. So again, before that, we have to build the program. So I will build the program, and now I can put the hex file in this Proteus software. Again, just double click on this, click on this folder, select the file, click on OK, and now I can run the program, right? So now this is the key which is connected to RB0. So when I press this key, this LED will be turned on, yellow LED will be turned on to indicate that key is pressed. And at the same time, you can observe over here that this bulb will be also on and this relay will also be activated. So I will just do it once again. So we can observe that the key is pressed, relay is on, and the bulb is also on. So this is how the program will work. The link for the source code and the Proteus simulation is available in the description of this video. Thank you.